Mr. Sweeney Todd, and I have opened a bottle of Pirelli's elixir. And I say to you, it is nothing but an arrant sham, concocted from piss and ink. Yet I'll wager that I can shave a cheek and pull a tooth with 10 times more dexterity than any street mountebank. You see these razors?
The finest in England.
I'll lay these against £5 that you are no match for me. Do you hear, sir? Either accept my challenge or prove yourself a sham.
The time.
charge.
Oh, to me, sir, to me, sir.
And who else? Anyone? Well, sir, since there is no means to test the second skill, I claim the £5.
To which he is entitled, right?
Wait, my mom, and wait. You, boy, get in that chair.
Who, me, sir? Oh, oh, not me too, sir. I ain't got a twinge about the slight.
You do not. We see who is the victor now, this Mr. Todd, or the great Pirelli.
Ready.
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 To pull that boot without an askin. God damn it, so rude. Now hold an askin. For if you slip, you grip a bit, you hit a bit, a bit, or deeper than deep, and have a tooth in. To pull in a tooth without a grace, you leave in a space all over the place. You try to erase without a place. Sometimes is the case, you even a kiss. To order the clamp, without a cramp, with all the saliva in the driver, you crazy, or butter or packer, you go to the gutter. I hold the clamp like a butter of heart. You take the paper, you take it all.
Sharon, share alike.
All right, Mr. Benjamin Barker.
Why do you call me that?
Well, at least you've got a nice, healthy head of hair on you.
Well, Mom, to tell you the truth, Mom, it gets awful hot.
You don't remember me. Why should you? I was just a down-and-out Irish lad you hired for a couple of weeks, sweeping up hair and such like. But I remember these. And you, Benjamin Barker, later transported to Botany Bay for life. So, Mr. Todd, do we have a deal? Or do I run down the street from me pal Beetle Bamford?
You think you're smart, you foolish boy. Tomorrow you start in my employ. You are a star, you like a my fly.
Signor Pirelli has been called away.
Where did he go?
He didn't say. Perhaps you should run after him.
Oh, no, sir. Not without orders to the contrary. I'd best wait for him. I'd best wait for him right here.
So, Mrs. Lovett gave you a pie, did she?
Yes, sir. She's a kind lady, sir. One whole pie!
Whole pie. Now, that isn't treason. Yet, if I know a growing lad, there's always room for more, isn't there?
I'd say, sir, an aching void.
Why don't you wait for your master downstairs? There'll be another pie in it for you.
And
tell Mrs. Lovett to give you a nice big tot of gin.
Ooh! Gin, sir? Thank you, sir. Thank you kindly. Jim, you're a Christian indeed, sir. Mom, the gentleman upstairs said to give me a nice tot of gin.
Gin, dear?